Hello everyone. Today I'm continuing my project of recycling the spark plugs in this tray, turning something old and forgotten into something useful again. In each video, I take one piece and give it a new purpose, combining creativity with practicality. I'm sure you're curious to see how it turns out. Stay with me until the end, the result might just surprise you. Here I have a short piece of wire ready. First, I'll connect one end of the wire to the threaded part of the spark plug, after loosening the contact point with the plug cap. Once the connection is made, I'll attach the other end of the wire to the threaded section of the spark plug. When the current flows through, this setup allows the transfer to be efficient, keeping the flow steady and consistent. That's why this step matters, even though it may look simple at first glance. That completes the first step. The connections are in place and everything is steady, ready for what comes next. Here I have a longer piece of wire. I'll connect one end of it to the ground section of the spark plug. Next, I'll wrap electrical tape around the connection I just made. This keeps the joint secure and adds a layer of safety while it's in use. If you've made it this far and enjoyed the topic, hit like, subscribe, leave a comment, and turn on the notification bell so you won't miss the upcoming videos. I believe the connection is solid. Now let's move on to making the handle with a PVC pipe. These PVC pieces were prepared in advance. Every measurement was planned with intention, so you can refer to the sizes shown on the video screen. Now I'll assemble the PVC pipe with the spark plug and wire, making it into a handheld welding tool. If you've prepared the materials with similar dimensions, assembling them won't be difficult. And if something feels unclear, just rewind and watch the part again. This part feels a bit loose, so I'll wrap some tissue around it to make the fit tighter. I think I should add some glue here. I'll use glue to secure the wrapped tissue, keeping it firm and preventing it from slipping out of the pipe. It feels solid enough, so now I'll take care of the other end of the wire. With this wire end, I'll attach a small alligator clip to complete the first tool of the homemade welding machine. Actually, I just realized it's still missing a welding tip. I'll get started on making it right away. I've just made a homemade welding tip from a battery core. Take a moment to look at it. If you're wondering how it was done, check out my previous videos. Now, let's attach it to the spark plug connector. The first tool is now complete. Curious about the second one? Let's move on to the next part. For the second tool, I've prepared a wire with one end already attached to an alligator clip, just like before. Now I only need to connect the other end to another clip, and it's done. Both tools are now complete. Let's head outside, set up the workspace, and test this homemade welding machine. To prepare the power source, I'll remove the battery from this electric drill. The specs of this battery seem ideal for powering the homemade welding device. With its capacity and voltage, it should provide a steady and sufficient current for the testing process. In my hand are two metal washers, used as intermediate electrical connectors. They attach to the positive and negative slots, linking directly to the two tools we just made. Watch the screen to see exactly how the connection is made. Before welding, I'll use a small piece of wood to support the object. Do you see the spark when the two terminals touch? It's like a reminder that you've made it work. I started welding with two thin razor blades, and I think this first test will be fairly easy to carry out. Honestly, this mini welder is really only suitable for small, manageable metal pieces, perfect for craft projects or small DIY experiments where high power isn't required. When approaching a project like this, it's important to understand the limitations of the tool to avoid overload or electrical hazards. I spent considerable time preparing, selecting the right wire, quality alligator clips, a stable power source, and even crafting a welding tip from a battery core to make sure everything was safe and functional. During welding, I placed each razor blade on a small piece of wood to hold it steady. It seems simple, but stability is crucial for a consistent weld. Once the clips are connected properly and the current flows, you can see sparks jump immediately. That moment is both thrilling and reassuring, a reminder that all the preparation and effort has paid off. With a mini welder, remember that thinner metal pieces are easier to control and less likely to be damaged. Thick or hard materials won't weld effectively and could overload the device. I experimented multiple times with various small metals, from razor blades and thin copper sheets to leftover metal pieces from old electronics. Every success brought satisfaction, and every failure offered valuable lessons. I learned how to adjust the gap between terminals, how to stabilize materials, and most importantly, how to make a clean, solid weld without damaging the device. Proper preparation of materials and tools is key. A well-made welding tip, secure alligator clips, and wires with the correct specifications ensure smooth operation. From removing the drill battery to use as a power source, to wrapping electrical tape and securing tissue with glue, every small step contributed to the final performance. Neglecting any of these could result in failure or even danger. Safety is also paramount. While welding, I always maintain a safe distance, wear protective glasses, and ensure there's nothing flammable nearby. The mini welder may be small, but it still generates heat and sparks, so respecting basic safety rules is essential. This is something I emphasize not only for myself but also for anyone following along to learn and apply it safely. After multiple attempts, I finally saw that the weld was satisfactory. It isn't fancy or industrial grade, but it works. Seeing the sparks jump gives a sense of pride, a tangible result from careful preparation, assembly, and testing. Each detail, from wrapping insulation tape, securing wires, to attaching the welding tip, shows that a homemade device, when done right, can indeed function. However, for me, it's not just about the device working. It's about the process of learning, experimenting, and exploring. Each step, adjustment, and trial provides knowledge, skills, and experience you can't get from theory alone. That's the true value of DIY. You create a product while also developing patience, observation, and problem-solving abilities. So, although this mini welder is only suited for small metals and craft projects, seeing it function is a big success for me. It proves that with simple materials, careful preparation, and some patience, anyone can create useful tools. And if you find this story interesting, don't forget to like, subscribe, comment, and share to support upcoming videos and share this DIY experience with others.